As the MLS playoffs kick off this weekend, the New England Revolution, winners of the Supporters Shield and single season points record holders, will be watching carefully to see who they host for the conference semifinals. To discuss their amazing run and the hope of finally winning MLS Cup is Carles Gil, the captain and star for the Revs, as well as a finalist for the Landon Donovan MLS MVP award. He joins me today as Qué Golazo begins right now. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Qué Golazo on this very special episode as we look ahead to the MLS playoffs. Thank you so much for watching youtube.com/Qué Golazo, CBS Sports, CBS Sports app, Apple Podcasts, and of course, Spotify and Stitcher. Right then, I wanted to introduce somebody I'm a very big fan of. He's done great things this season as his New England Revolution get ready for the playoffs. Carles Gil. Carles, ¿cómo estás? How are you, my friend?
Very well, thank you.
Carles, I've told everybody, by the way, that we're doing this in English, but at any point he wants to express himself in Spanish, he can do it, and we will translate. But Carles, welcome to the show. Congratulations on a fantastic regular season and winning the Supporters Shield. How are you feeling about the playoffs?
Thank you. We did an amazing season, you know, with a record of point records and winning the cup. And now it's another thing because it's for me it's like a different competition. It's one game. If you lose, you go home. So yeah, we are focused on the playoff. We had 2-3 weeks off for prepare the game, for see against who we play, and yeah, try to train hard and be focused.
So you mentioned, obviously, we have to wait and see if it's Atlanta United or NYCFC. We'll get to that in a second, but you mentioned, obviously, getting the single season points record for the league ever, 73 points. Increíble. How important was it for the team, do you think, to reach this record? What do you think it meant for the New England Revolution to get 73 points in the season?
Yeah, it's incredible what we did. I think we before we start the season, we know like we want to do something important to be in the first place. But you know, you never think like you will do the record point. So yeah, we are very happy for that and for the way that we did. You know, I think we won many games, we play good, and yes, we are very happy and now focus on the playoffs.
You've been here for a few years now, obviously one of them being during the worst of COVID and stuff, but you know MLS, you understand it, obviously you do so well there, but you mentioned, you know, it's a bit different, right, from Europe. It's regular season and then a playoffs, and it's like you bet, you know, it's like two different seasons, right? Dos diferentes temporadas. Is that how you feel? Like you feel like you have to now recharge and think, okay, now I have to think about the playoffs, which is totally different.
Yes, it's like I said, for me it's a different competition. I think we did the most difficult because it's a regular season, many games against everyone, you know, so. And we did amazing, and now yes, it's different. It's one game, you lose, you go home. Bad game, bad moments, you go home. So you need to be more focused. We know that we play at home, and that is very good for us. So yeah, we will try to win because we won't win everything this year.
All right, let's talk about you for a second. And this season, 18 assists, 4 goals. You're a finalist for the MVP award. How do you think you've done this season, your own objectives?
Yes, I think I good. No, I try always to help my team to win the games. Yes, I'm happy. I had an injury that was a little bit difficult for me, but after that I feel good. So yes, I think we show like this year we are a team because we had some important injuries, the international's break, you know, and the team feel the same. We continue to win games, you know, to win games. So I think was the important part this year. Like we don't care about who is playing in the moment. We win games too, so we are really happy for that.
What does it mean for you to be captain as well? Because you're not just a star of the team, but you are the leader on the pitch. Is that specifically important to you that you're captain of this team?
Yes, of course. I'm very proud of that. And very happy to be the captain here. And yes, of course, always you are a captain. You need to show why, you know, why you are the captain. I'm very happy here with my teammates, with everyone, and also to be the captain.
Are you thinking at all about the MVP award? Do you care? I'm sure you care a little bit, right? That you're a finalist for the MVP award?
Yes, of course. It's an important thing because I think it's very difficult to be in this list. If you see how many players is not in this list, you feel like it's too difficult. So of course it's important for me, for the club, because I think they put my name, but I represent the New England Revolution, like Matt or Tajon or Bruce in the others individuals things. So yes, of course this is important.
Very good answer, Carlos Hill. Muy diplomático ahí. Very diplomatic there. Hey,
always.
Listen, exactly. I wanted to ask you something, actually. I talk to a lot of MLS players, right, that come from Europe or South America, and I always ask them this, and I would love to hear your answer. Many enter MLS, and they realize, wow, this league is really more advanced than most people think outside of the United States. What do you say?
Yeah, I think exactly the same. Me too. I had this problem like when I didn't play here because you don't know the league and you only know that the people say, you know. So many people talk about this league and maybe they didn't watch one game, you know.
Right.
So yes, I think it's easy to see how is improving this league year by year, the players that are coming here. And it's a very competitive league. Every team can win you never know. I think, I don't know how many people say like we will win the title, you know, and did the record. So yeah, I think it's a very good league and it's improving every year and that is very difficult.
Carlos, your English is very good. I'm very impressed doing this. Poco a poco. Are you taking lessons? Are you just talking every day with teammates? How's that working?
Yeah, I took lessons in the beginning. I came and yeah, with my teammates also in Aston Villa. I learned a little, you know. So
we'll
yeah.
talk about that in a second.
I know.
So that means you don't want to get a Birmingham accent and a Boston accent. That's too much, Carlos Hill. Is that
Birmingham accent is more difficult.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I totally agree. All right, let's talk about, you know, how much you think the Revolution has changed since you joined. As I mentioned, you joined in 2019 from Deportivo La Coruña. How much has the New England Revolution changed since you came in 2019?
Yes, I think many things changed. The mentality, I think, also when Bruce came, you know, he's a winner, he's a legend here. So I think he tried to put in our mind his mentality to try to be a winner, and I think he did that. And yes, I think the club is improving every year. We have better players, everything, you know, more fans every day in the stadium. That's important for us. And yes, we are very happy for that, and hopefully we continue like that many years.
You mentioned Bruce Arena. Some would say, definitely in the U.S., the greatest ever male American coach. He's won the MLS Cup five times as a head coach, and you mentioned the winning mentality. Is that something that he has given you, do you think? Even though you obviously are so experienced, but have you seen, you know, because he's famous for just that winning, gritty mentality. You see that every day with Bruce Arena?
Yes, it's, I think the first thing that you see when you know him, you know, and when he came, we had in a very bad position in the league. Our last two games, we lose 6-0, 1-0, 5-0, I think. So, and he came, we made the playoff, and now we did an amazing season. So, yes, he's a winner. And like you say, he won five times the MLS Cup. It's so hard. This club did five finals and lose the five finals. So, yeah, he's a winner.
He can help there. Ahí te puede ayudar.
Hopefully, yeah.
Here's a question, though. You don't play either Atlanta United or NYCFC until next week. So that's another week where you have to train and wait and no 90-minute competition. Mm-hmm. Do you think that's a problem, you know, just waiting so long to play?
Well, it depends, I think, the way that you train or you focus these weeks. Yeah. We will have some games, some friendly games, you know, for try to be fit and feel like we play some games before that. And no, I think it's good for us. We're trying hard, and we will be perfect for this game.
I wanted to ask you about two teammates of yours, Matt Turner and Tajon Buchanan. Obviously, CONCACAF players, they're competing against each other in qualifiers in the future. How do you see them, you know, over the last 2 years? Very important players, not just for the Revs, but for their countries as well. How do you see them as your teammates?
Yeah, I think the way that they improve this time, these 2 years, is incredible. They shown 1 year ago, 1 year and a half ago, when the maybe the 18 in the team, you know, and every day he's improving and competitive, and also his incredible quality, you know, for 1v1 and for his speed and everything. And yeah, he's now a very good player. And Matt also, no, Matt is for me the best goalkeeper in the league, in USA, and he showed that every game. And yeah, I'm very happy for both.
Let's move on about your life in Boston and in New England. When you joined the Revolution, you know, obviously there's a massive team in New England, the New England Patriots, right, from the NFL. They've always been so big, Super Bowl champions, obviously the Tom Brady years, etc. Both organizations owned by Robert Kraft. But the Revs now, I feel, you know, are getting bigger. Do you feel the soccer community in Boston and New England is growing and you're seeing more and more when you play at home, especially?
Yes. It's like I say, we have big fans, more fans coming to the stadium. That is important for us. Also, we have a big team with the Patriots. I think it's good for us. It's a mirror for us, and yes, we are very happy for that, and hopefully we will have many fans for the playoffs games, and they for sure help us to try to win these games.
Yeah, that's a good point about the Patriots. They're a mirror for you. Mm-hmm. They can show you what you can do and how you can be successful as well. Yeah. How about la comunidad española, Carlos? Hay españoles ahí en Boston. You see a lot of. Is there any good paella restaurants in Boston?
Yeah. You can go to some Spanish restaurant, and yes, more Latinos, you know, like
of course
Spanish people, but yes, you where you go, restaurant, shopping, or it depends. You can see some gente que habla español, you know.
Yep, people that speak Spanish. Yeah,
Spanish. So yeah, that's fine, you know, because sometimes it's difficult for us to speak or understand something. So yes.
Well, do you miss Spain at all, Carlos?
Yes, of course I miss my family, but I'm very happy here.
Yeah, no, absolutely. All right, listen, we're nearly done here with Carlos Hill, New England Revolution, Qué Golazo. Thank you so much for being here. Bueno, I did want to ask you, Carlos Hill, as you know, as you can see behind me, I'm a lifelong Aston Villa fan. if you don't know anybody, Carlos Hill scored one of the greatest goals Aston Villa has ever seen. You remember that one? Adama Traore crossing it for you?
I remember, yeah.
How was your time with Villa? Did you enjoy it? I mean, it was a difficult time, but yes. Villa fans were we loved you, and we thought that you deserved to stay with us a little longer. How did you experience Aston Villa?
Yes, it was, like you say, difficult moments for the club. I feel like sometimes up, sometimes down, you know. I think I was very young. In the beginning, when I arrived, I feel very good, my first 2-3 months. And then, you know, we changed the train, and he decided I didn't play. So it's like I say, like, I think I was younger because for me, for my mind, was very difficult first time that I leave my country, Spain, you know.
Yeah.
And I feel strange. Then next year we were relegated to championship. So yeah, but also I enjoy some moments, some goals, and this big club, big fans, is amazing, and I'm so proud to be part of this club.
Yeah, and it really has helped you, I think, right? Become a better player, playing away from Spain and now living.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. What do you think of Steven Gerrard as a new manager? That's interesting, huh?
Yes, I took with Matt Polse that he had him in Rangers.
Yeah, that's right.
And yes, he has lucky. I think he showed very good things. Also, was a top player and very good manager. And hopefully, he has a very good times in Villa.
Absolutely. All right. Well, let's finish off then with New England Revolution as you get ready to the playoffs, Carlos Hill. How confident are you with Bruce Arena? I know that this might be a silly question, but can you win it all? Are you confident in this squad, despite the fact that you haven't played in a while? ¿Lo pueden ganar todo? Can you win it all, this MLS Cup?
Yes, I think so, and I hope so. In my mind, I only have win. So yes, hopefully, I know it will be very difficult. It's a different games. We don't know against New York City or Atlanta, but we played this year against them, but we know that will be a very different game because a playoff is a different thing. And yes, will be hard, will be difficult, but I think we show that we did all the season, and with the fans, hopefully we can win the cup and make an historic season.
You are a Bruce Arena player. You only have win in your mind. I love it. I love it. Carles Gil, muchísimas gracias. Thank you so much for being part of the show. New England Revolution enter the playoffs in the conference semifinals, waiting for the winner of Atlanta United or NYCFC. Carles Gil, muchísimas gracias, campeón. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Muchas gracias a ti. Un placer.
Thank you, everybody. Make sure to follow us on youtube.com/Qué Golazo and subscribe. Qué Golazo Pod on Twitter, CBS Sports, and your CBS Sports app, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and Stitcher. We will see you next time.